Hi, my name is Julian Woodhouse. I'm the CEO of Woodhouse Army, a made-to-order brand founded in Seoul, currently located in New York. We've been in business since 2015. We were the first black brand to show at Seoul Fashion Week in Korea. And we quickly showed through New York Fashion Week, several seasons. And yeah, we are interested in fusing technology with fashion, as well as playing around with gender and different types of expressions. Founded the brand in 2015. I founded it myself, actually. I was in the military, stationed in Korea, and really I was just looking for a way to make clothing that really fit who I was as a person. I found myself going shopping at fast fashion stores and different stores that I was that were in the area, but I would go to the men's section and I would be underwhelmed or completely. And then I would go to the women's section, and then I would realize that the measurements didn't match my body. And so instead of, you know, being upset about it, I just got creative and found a tailor that was stationed right outside of my military base. And that seamstress and I would work together to build clothes for parties, clothes for events, clothes for fashion week, just for experimentation. That lasted for about a year, and eventually I got the idea to start a brand, to turn this into a brand.
Julian and Haley!
Hi!
Hi!
How are you getting along?
Well, just from like two different black dresses.
I'm menswear.
Yeah, I'm womenswear.
Yeah.
Quite simple.
And I'm over the top.
About a year after the Phoenix collection, I was contacted by a casting director through Instagram. He slid in my DMs and asked me if I wanted to be on a fashion design competition show. Now, given the fact that we've always worked with seamstresses, I didn't learn how to sew the traditional way. I was terrified of that idea. I was like, I'm gonna be on set and I'm gonna have to sew these clothes together, and I don't know how to sew yet. But you know, it was an interesting proposal at the time, but I declined it, actually, and, you know, stopped thinking about it. About 2 months later, another casting director reached out to me and asked me the same question, and I was like, all right, God, what is it? Maybe I should do the show.
I don't sleep with my parents.
Okay.
Yeah, we're on an anti-gay situation.
Okay.
It's pretty intense. Both of my parents from the Army. When I first came out to my parents, my mom, you know, she's in tears, my dad's like freaking out, and, you know, we tried piecing things together. It just didn't really work out. So I divorced my parents, in a sense. It takes a lot to grow up in this society, as beautiful and diverse as it is, and be who you are. I was able to come to grips with myself, and now I'm Julian Woodhouse.
I'll just learn how to sew. I don't think it's that difficult, so. Learned how to sew, I trained myself, got a sewing machine. Kirill actually got me a sewing machine. And learned how to sew, and Kirill and I were always looking at, you know, the things that I was making during the day, and I was really picking it up. So by the time I got to the show, I was actually quite confident with sewing. And I was ready to figure out what this experience was gonna be. So the show, as you know, is a partner competition, so I did have a partner. And my partner and I actually didn't work really well together, which was such a surprise, because, you know, when they say begin, your time starts now, it's time for you to make magic out of 3 hours or so, you know, you expect your partner to kind of initiate and just be right there with you, but that's more so my military side creeping in. you know, Haley wasn't really the same type of creative spirit as I am. It takes her a little bit more time to process and feel and then express. So that was definitely a barrier for us to get through. And so, but the experience itself was one of the best experiences I've had in my life as a designer. To work with other creative people, even though I wasn't necessarily on their team, just to be in the same workspace and seeing them go through their creative process and going through my creative process as well, was just really, it felt like a warm family, to be honest. All of the cast members were really close. Inspiration is the entire game when it comes to being a creative director or a designer. I advise, you know, always look for inspiration. Sometimes inspiration isn't necessarily going to find you. You may not stumble on this inspiration, but if you're looking for it and you have your mind turned on to inspiration, I think that that can really be, you know, an experience where you can get great, great things from different sources. I'm on social media all the time, just like, you know, the majority of us. And I'm always looking at what's happening. I'm always looking at what's happening in other countries. I'm always looking at what's happening in men's wear, within women's wear, within gender fluid wear as well. But that inspiration is something that doesn't always, like, it doesn't always come as easy. As a creative director and a CEO, there are different times in my life where I find inspiration is easy to come upon versus difficult times where I'm more so focused on the numbers. The main thing that I learned from that experience was I have within me something that no one else has, and other people have that same experience. And so really it's about owning that energy that is within you, owning that creative expression, and not compromising that.